start by talking about how our collaboration came about and about the last year's exhibitions that were also on the title Ground. That kind of gives a foundation for this exhibition. So we started working together sort of by accident from noticing our shared interest in maybe how an artwork can possess some kind of quality of the artist being there even if they're not present in the artwork in the end. So some sort of feeling of the body making the artwork, or the artwork is kind of in a state of
transition.
And how a set of materials could somehow reflect a body in some way, whether that is scale or feeling of touch or time spent with a material.
So me and Alice both have a studio on Thoresby Street, which is a studio in Nottingham, and a gallery as well. And we started off Ground in the gallery space on Thoresby Street. We curated three shows there, which were all duo shows. And it was kind of a little comment, it was mainly a reflection on us two as collaborators. They were all duo shows. There was like a dialogue between the artists involved. So we would, before we decided to collaborate together on exhibition making, we would just be in on day to day and we'd just speak to each other casually. And then there was like commonalities, like that we were interested in like similar things, like we started speaking about ideas of performativity and artworks, whether that be sculptural artworks or live artworks. So like in terms of Ground, like I was looking at the sculptural practice as more performative, whereas Alice is more looking at live elements as live characteristics in art making as performative. It's a bit more of an obvious way of looking at sculpture.
Or maybe the body activating a material, and you see that happening within the artwork, or you see the artwork being made, and that is the artwork itself. Whereas maybe, yeah, there's a kind of within our interest, there's sort of either that sort of before moment, during moment, or after moment, where somehow the work is always kind of in relation to you being there, making it, spending time with that material and a particular action, perhaps.
So it's another thing to note that when we did our first shows, we laid this new floor down in the gallery, which represented the ground. And our interest in the idea of ground was that idea of like a foundation, an architectural foundation, and how things are built on foundations. So there needs to be a beginning point for something to happen. So we use this floor as a device so activity could happen, curatorial like practice could happen.
It was sort of like a backdrop for putting these three different shows in, so the shows would be different but the floor remained the same.
Yeah, so there'd be like, yeah, that idea of like our presence within the exhibition would be there, but we would be there physically.
And the floor that it was like a problem solving exercise, because we really didn't like the floor in this gallery that we were using, so we're somehow sort of putting another floor on, was almost like superimposing a new kind of, almost like a new space within the shell of the space that was already existing there. And I suppose that our interests are kind of related to that, about maybe what happens somewhere else, how does that get transported into a gallery space? And how do you kind of remain true to something that happened maybe in a studio space or outside of a studio space, and how does that kind of sense translate in the gallery?
So maybe moving on from what we've done in the past to like this show.
So if we kind of took that idea of maquette and thought about that in relation to ground, I think probably more in this show than we did at the other shows. And so the maquette kind of pops up in Adrian Eulalia's work, which is the video behind you, which does have sound, which we'll put on later, where they've constructed this model of this building that they're walking around, and within the audio they talk through the materials that they use for the maquette and the materials that are used for the real thing, and they're kind of drawing these kind of comparisons and also sort of almost like not making distinctions between one or the other, sort of. And then at the end of the film they talk about their maquette is the original in their eyes. So it's almost as if the maquette that came after was...
Yeah, that makes you think about the real thing, so in thinking about the real thing, is that like, yeah, the thing, or do you need the building? If you can look at a maquette and imagine the fully formed thing.
And what's quite interesting within their film is that they're carrying a building in their hands, and there's kind of interesting thing about scale happening, where almost kind of possessing this building in the palm of your hand, what does that mean, and how do you relate to that building, therefore, if you're kind of suddenly at a completely different scale to it. Maquette also comes into Sean Inwood's work, which is seen in the sculpture and then in the enlarged image of the sculpture here. Sean kind of talks about works appearing in the gallery and not necessarily, it's kind of interest in them not necessarily being finished. They're kind of caught in like a state of development and shown in that way, and we kind of presume that they might continue on from this point.
He also speaks about the studio a lot in relation to his practice, and I think the reason why we both like Sean's work is that idea of being in the studio, you very much have the present in the studio and making work. Yeah, the body of these particular, there's a section of work Sean calls these practice objects. So this is one of the practice objects, and like these things made from remains of previous artworks, or they're like offcuts of another activity, but then often get incidentally wrapped like this one, and then they're left, and later on there'll be a realisation of its potential in the objects.
In these leftovers. I think like this is a prime example of the work in the show for me, for both of us, is has a very kind of casual feeling about it. It's sort of the work when you look up. When you look at it up close, there's not really, it's not really hidden as to how this kind of polished object is made, because it's not a polished object, it's sort of just left as it is. And I think that there's something quite interesting about this kind of approachability to that. We're thinking about Lynn's work, which is these sculptures down here. as the way she uses materials could almost be thought of as very sort of basic, not in a negative sense, but in a sort of immediate sense, in the same way that Maquette might be sort of just placing materials together to do what you need it to do, and that's all it needs to do. And I think that Lynn seems to work in that way, but in a much bigger scale, sort of a Maquette on a real life scale, I suppose.
You know, forms and beads may or may not allude to aerial views and landscapes.
Mm-hmm. And in that sense, they're sort of huge scale, aren't they, if you think of them like that.
Mm-hmm. But they're also miniaturised. Mm-hmm. And they're like, on the ground, being close to the ground, where you can kind of really look into them. And there's a name there, yeah.
She also spoke about, she didn't want them to be fixed in this way, but she spoke about when you're in a kind of clothes shop and the clothes are kind of folded in piles. I think she was sort of relating that to maybe where the body comes into the work, in the sense that the clothes are like awaiting a body inside them. And also you can kind of, you imagine what that item of clothing looks like, even when it's folded. You kind of imagine that action of unfolding it and it sort of becoming this 3D thing that can be worn. So I think that's quite interesting in terms of thinking about sort of something being compacted and then being sort of, if it was expanded outwards, it would sort of come alive or somehow sort of become this 3D thing to accommodate. I think we should sort of talk about Lucy Vann's work in relation to this. So Lucy's work is the text pieces that are inside the gallery, out on the pavement and in the toilet. And she's also got an audio piece in the toilet as well. And Lucy was talking to us quite a lot about this sense of, she's been spending some time in East Croydon making this work, and this sense of wandering around shopping malls, and this being a kind of disorientating experience where you kind of lose sense of where you're going or what you're meant to be doing there. And the signage is kind of meant for you, but not meant for you. Sometimes it relates to you, sometimes it doesn't, depending on why you're there or what you're looking for or what you're not looking for.
A transition, wasn't it, between, so when you kind of walk through places, you see like multiple things, and there's more, then you go through various transitions as you move. And thinking about that in relation to, was it architecture, like that idea of looking at these things and getting, seeing potential in them or adding language to them.
I think also about passing through things, and how do you capture that sense in a gallery space, maybe. Sort of passing through an artwork or then returning to an artwork, and maybe you kind of capture something else of it that you didn't get before. I think we do want that sense of kind of maybe wandering around things, or sort of this sense of crouching down on things.
Being aware of like yourself when you're in like a...
Yeah.
When you're here, witnessing, looking at the artworks, maybe. Trying to read like nuances and things and celebrating. how that needs to be up.
I think it's also about things just being as like as they are, or as they were in the situation that they were made or that they were encountered, and there not being like an apology about that.
Is there any like questions that anyone would like to ask? Maybe that's a good way to do something like that.
I have to decide where to put everything. That's a bit general,
but
I always wonder how you decide that goes there or that goes there.
Well, with Lynn's work, she made the so the painted polythene was made outside of a gallery, it was made in her studio. And she, when she came to install, this structure was made based on her being in the space. She often like works in the gallery to construct a lot of she makes things like furniture, like construction things, often with works, and they're really reliant upon the materials that are available normally in the area, so she'll just salvage materials, or she'll. So this is some way relational to the window, so it's partly made to fit in the confines of this area. So Lynn's work was when we did have the conversation, it's been slight movements. It's made her work was decided. We didn't really decide how that was placed.
Yeah.
We let that happen.
What about the lighting? I mean, if you were to show this at night, would it affect the work?
Probably will.
It would, yeah. The sun like comes through this window at a certain time of day, and it kind of bathes the sculpture in light.
I think one thing also to mention was this, going back to this clothing idea, she sort of wanted it to be like a shop display, because we're around two like shopping malls, and she was maybe kind of thinking about what we were talking about, like these kind of piles of clothing, it being something that you can see from the outside, and it was almost like a kind of display.
And perhaps it isn't meant to be a thing that's read in the work, but it's a methodology that you could apply to help decision making. So you're not just coming into a gallery space with this blank mind, but you've got this set yourself a set of rules which then perhaps could be abided, and then there's room for you to negate those things that might make perhaps an unexpected outcome.
But in
relation to lighting, I think with this show we didn't want to have like things like spotlight, for instance. We just wanted it to be like this, just plain like way of experiencing something, like, but just not to like put this like if it's something spotlight, you've got this boundary around it, and it just makes it gives it this, like, I don't know, like some sort of status, or you just want it to like be as you would perhaps see it in more everyday setting.
I suppose it will be interesting to see when it's dark, than tonight, for example, that this almost might seem even more like a window display from it being sort of bright in here and being dark outside for those that are walking past. I think there's also something about, in terms of like where to place things, I think it's often like just a quite simple thing about like you have to start somewhere, and then the next piece that comes in has to somehow work with the initial piece, and then the third piece, and then suddenly like the first piece has to move because when all the work is in there, suddenly you've kind of I think it's just like a sense, isn't it? We were
speaking about things like perhaps like revealing themselves as in more grand space. So for like Sean's work, for instance, maybe it's not successful, but if you like walk into the space, you like see the photographed earth, and you kind of consider it as an image. And then perhaps later on in the show, you'll see the actual work in the corner. And, you know, you're a different frame, like your eye is in a different frame looking at the work here as it is to looking there. You probably perhaps can see them in relation to one another, but there's a moment where you don't look at one, don't look at the other. And I think that like work, that was the sculpture actually, was like the last thing we placed. Like we kept on moving it, and it kind of stayed in that area, and we were like moving it back a little bit, and closer to the pipe.
And the pipe was sort of huge in relation to it.
It turns the pipe into like an architecture.
I think that's what's really nice about curating artworks, because they're sort of, in a way, like the artists have to kind of relinquish part of the control of that, because you're there kind of making sense of like how does it relate to this space.
Yeah.
But I think that's an interest of ours. Some people, it would be an interest to make it relate to a gallery space because it's a completely pristine space. But I think when you've got a gallery that's sort of in an ex shop space attached to a shopping mall, that's got all these kind of architectural features, and I think you have to kind of think about the history of the space, or what's it like me putting this new thing in here, and does it relate to anything else around? Because if it does, then do I acknowledge that? Do I ignore that? And I think that strengthens can strengthen the work in a way, or change its sort of potential meanings.
Yeah, it's making sure that the work actually remains like this physical thing. Because, you know, in a gallery space, like it's white and everything like levitates. And it doesn't, you're not meant to consider the space. Maybe people do now, but traditionally you're not meant to consider the gallery space. It's meant to just be this neutral, like a void. And like little things like, you know, the floor, you can see like cracks in it, and little bits of carpet fluff. Just like really like ground like these things in like physical space. Quite looks great. Yeah.
Would you say out of these two, which is inevitable to the other one, like you're saying?
The
other one, is the footnote to this, or is it?
Well, the sculptures, the first work sculpture is made number of years before the photograph.
But in terms of its display here, throws it out, because that's the long
That's
the first place.
These practice objects were all documented by a professional documenter, and this photograph, Sean didn't make this photograph, it was by a documenter. So that the documenting my artwork has been like it's been shown for like commercial purposes, but then in that through that time there's been like a realisation that this is like could be a new work, and that's wow.
I think it's also about when you define something's something. I think what's interesting about Lucy's work, which you can go and hear in the toilet, is that it's completely based around the framing of it. It's these kind of recordings from shopping malls and these dialogues that happen between different people, the woman in the lift telling you where you are. I think it's sort of about navigating yourself within a space. And it doesn't necessarily have to be about a shopping mall, but it's about you and how do you fit within these kind of spaces. And how can you like digest your surroundings, or how can you make sense of them? Can you?